Full disclosure, a review copy of this game was provided to me either by its publisher or development team.
Cake Bash, pretty sweet. Cake Bash is a four-player minigame based competitive game that can be played either local or online, and here you play as a pastry of your choice with only one goal, to become the tastiest. Be the tastiest pastry by the end of this 20-minute series of minigames. And for the most part, I had an absolute blast with this game. Each round the players vote on a game to play, all of which you'll be chasing high scores, and some you'll be taking on the other three players, collecting jelly beans, bashing each other to knock them off, breaking fortune cookies, throwing in berries to a pie, roasting marshmallows, just to name a few. And dependent on how you do, you'll earn coins that can be spent when it comes time to do some topping shopping. And this is how you become the tastiest, saving up for the best topping and collecting three of those toppings to upgrade it to a topping worth more points. And whoever has the most points by the end of the game wins. With robots, this is very easy to do, but when real players get involved, there's tons of strategy at play here. For starters, the first player to win the first game has the ultimate advantage, as they'll be the only person during the first shopping stop to be able to afford the most expensive topping if one is available, already putting them onto the path for success. However, there is a little luck machine on the side for those not as fortunate. These little mystery balls cost half as much as the regular toppings, but can reward you with not only regular toppings, but even the most expensive topping for a fraction of the price. So if you're down on your luck, you have that machine to possibly give you the edge you need to come out on top. However, there's also the risk of getting moldy cheese or fish bones attached to you, and you'll need to pay the same amount of coins to discard them. So there is a risk, as these items can take a hefty amount of points away from you in the end. My biggest complaint with Cake Bash though, is that there just isn't enough variety to the game modes. It will take 3.5 hours to unlock all the places and modes, but getting to the end of this rainbow really starts to become quite repetitive and boring in the final hour, only at the fault of playing the same thing over and over, always having to do a cookie bash, always having to play Sweet Victory at the end. I need some variety in each of my playthroughs, and playing the same minigame but on a different map with different hazards just isn't enough. There's only so many times I can beat up a cookie or uppercut a muffin that has too many jelly beans attached to it, at least in a row. Another complaint I have is how Cake Bash saves progress. I'm not sure when or how it does, but there is a metagame of completing challenges to unlock new versions of the characters you can choose. And a game crash caused me to lose over 20% of my game progress, which was about an hour or so of playtime loss. That's about 3 rounds, so the game didn't even save my progress in between each round. Thankfully, some of the harder challenges were remembered, but some of the tedious ones were not, which is quite frustrating. Overall though, my girlfriend and I loved being cupcakes and donuts, bashing each other with spoons and dodging pigeons, forks, and knives. It was the final grind to unlock everything that only I had to endure that left me craving more in this game of sweets. I give Cake Bash a 7.5 out of 10. If you played Cake Bash, tell me what you thought about it down in the comment section below. If you haven't played it, tell me if you plan on picking it up. Thumbs up. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram at SuperKenGaming. Thanks for watching, and of course, stay beautiful. If you thought that video was good, ha! You should probably watch this video. The very video that's on your screen right now that YouTube hand-selected for you. Out of all my thousands of videos, this is the one that it wants you to watch next. And make sure you're subscribed, because I'm not a genie or anything, but I'm pretty sure you get 42 years of bad luck if you made it this far into my video and you're not subscribed. You don't have to subscribe, but I'm just looking out for you. I'm just looking out for your luck and your life.